呐。
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening?
That's in the rain,
snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Out in the wonderland, gone away.
Yes, Pastor?
Nancy, do me a favor. Get my wife, get Myra, get a meeting together. We got to talk about this Christmas production.
Okay.
Christmas is just a few weeks away and we still don't have the children's Christmas production ready. Come on, we have to get it together.
Let's go with my idea of a huge toy store. We can have the kids, yes, dress up as toys. We can have them as toy soldiers and we can have Christmas dolls and teddy bears. I can see them now. Oh, and we can decorate. We can decorate with backdrops of a toy scenery and we can have gumdrops and candy canes. Oh, I can see it now. We'll call it the Joy Store.
Now that Christmas is here, step into our store.
Okay, you know what, Myra? Toys, yes, they're an important part of Christmas, but what is a children's Christmas production without a manger scene? I could see it now. We could use the little lambs. We never use the little lambs. We could dress them up like angels, put them on stage. We have to have a Mary, a Joseph, and of course, the three wise men. Look, what everybody longs to see is a nice winter wonderland scene. You know, kids that dressed up in their snow suits looking like cute little bunnies, riding on the sleigh, and lots of snow.
To together with you.
Sure, snow is nice, Nancy, but you can't have a children's Christmas production, people, without a manger scene. I could see it now. Okay. You have to have Mary. Here is in some serious need of counseling. And let's just say, she lives with you.
That's not funny.
But you know what, Nancy? You have a point. That's it. In my counseling sessions during this Christmas season, people always come to me that they're talking about how they're depressed. They tell me they just can't shake off those Christmas blues.
This Christmas, I wish everyone was well, so I could get a break
Come on, come on, hurry it up. Move it right along, let's go.
Here we are, Dr. Newhart's clinic.
A hospital?
Oh, no!
Look, TJ, you and Wendy want to feel better, don't you?
We all do.
Yeah, I don't know what's wrong with me.
Yeah.
Believe me, Corey, I understand. That's why I brought you all here. Nurse Philpott, my friends need to see the doctor.
And fast!
And what's your problem?
Our problem?
I mean, you're kidding me, right?
But why don't you just, like, have a seat? The doctor will be in here shortly.
Excuse me, Nurse Fusspot?
That's Nurse Philpott.
What's Dr. Newhart like?
Dr. Newhart? Why, Dr. Newhart?
Dr. Newhart, how do you do? Well, anyone could tell what's wrong with you. Your joy is jump the wagon, your fun is blood to tell. Christmas is here, but you're feeling down. I'm Dr. Newhart, and I'm pretty wise. think that I can help you. At least I'll do my best. But first I need to ask you to take a little test.
Dr. Newhart.
That's me.
Dr. Newhart.
Will you say ah?
Ah!
Stick out your tongue. Now stretch your arm in front of you, just one. Close your eyes and touch your nose. Take your time. Very good, now will you cough? That sounds fine. Now take a breath. Now give a sigh. Now place your right hand over your right eye. Count the fingers that you see.
One, two, three.
Very good, now hear me. Repeat after me. Dr. Newhart.
Dr. Newhart.
Dr. Newhart.
Dr. Newhart.
Excellent.
Can we be sure you've got a cure? Dr. Newhart. Do the trick, does it stick? I'm feeling so good.
I can see that.
Dr. Newhart.
That's me.
Dr. Newhart.
Again.
You too, Dr. Newhart.
I take it your friends have the CDDs, Christmas Day dumps.
Yeah, they all got tons of stuff for Christmas, but
they still aren't happy.
You got it.
Can you help us?
Well, I'm afraid that the Christmas Day dumps is just a symptom of something far more serious.
Oh, no!
Nurse Philpott, page my interns.
Paging Dr. Frick, paging Dr. Frack, paging Drs. Frick and Frack.
Who are they?
They're young doctors who are still studying medicine.
Why do you call them interns?
I think you'll see. Oh, did she say Dr. Frack?
Yes, she said Dr.
Frick. I'm certain I heard her say Dr. Frack. No, no, I certainly heard her. Let's find out.
Dr. Newhart, do you have a patient for me to see?
Oh, but Dr. Frick. Dr. Frick, it's my turn.
No, it's my turn.
Dr. Frick, it's my turn.
You had your turn last
time. Dr. Frick. Now, doctors, you both get a turn. See what I mean? Interns. Ah, patience.
Do you have a stomachache?
Do you have a headache?
Do you have a toothache?
Do you have a heartache?
A heartache? Ew! I don't even like girls.
Oh, TJ, your heart isn't just for that. Your heart does lots of things.
Dr. Newhart, I have an idea. I think we should start by having a look inside their bodies.
Inside our bodies? Oh, no!
Excuse me.
You look like a very good specimen. First, we will begin at the bottom. First, we see the phalanges.
The metatarsus.
The tarsus.
The tibia.
The fibula.
The patella.
The femur.
Excuse me, excuse me. Why don't you teach them the way I taught you? Ah, the bone song.
The ankle bone's connected to the leg bone. The leg bone's connected to the knee bone. The knee bone's connected to the thigh bone. And the thigh bone's connected to the hip. But the heart, now that's the Lord's favorite part. The heart.
Connected to the arm bone, and the arm bone's connected to
to the shoulder bone, and the shoulder bone's connected to the neck.
But the heart,
oh, the heart,
the heart,
yes, the heart.
Now that's the Lord's favorite part. The heart is connected to all you do. The heart, that's you.
All you think and all you say. Every choice you make each day. Hear my diagnosis. I diagnosed this to be heart trouble.
Oh my goodness, Dr. Frick, that's exactly what I was going to say.
Yes, but it's not your turn.
Now, doctors, I believe you're both right. This is a heart problem.
Oh no!
Nurse Philpott, we need to finish this examination. Would you record my observations, please?
Okie dokie, doc.
Now, of the following items, which did you receive for Christmas? You may indicate by the raised hand.
She'd better have one long list.
Yeah, I can remember everything I got.
Ready?
Ready.
New coat, new clothes, new books, new bows, new boat, new bike, new truck, new trike, new doll, new cat, new ball, new bat, new games, new dart, new desk, new heart, new...
New heart?
Hey, hang on there. Nobody raised their hand for the last one. What was that again?
A new heart.
Did anybody here get a new heart for Christmas?
Mm-hmm.
Not one, Doc.
Well, that just might be the problem.
But I've never heard of asking for a new heart for Christmas.
Oh, TJ, here's what I tell all my patients. It's really something very special. I need you to listen carefully. There are lots of things you want when Christmas rolls around. Lots of things upon your Christmas list. But won't you say the spades when you write them down? And when you do, won't you remember this? You need a new heart for Christmas, a new start for Christmas, a new way to face a brand new year. You need a new kind of love from the Savior above, a new heart. Thank you.
minute. If we need a new heart, what's wrong with the one we've got?
It probably has a hole in it.
Oh, no! Whoa, before we go any further, I demand a second opinion. Just be patient, Corey.
Make way, make way, make way, make way!
Emergency, emergency, woo!
Hold on, you clown. Stop it right there.
Hiya, gorgeous.
Woo!
Nurse Philpot. You're a heartbreaker.
Dr. Newhart.
Okay, you guys, cut the clowning around.
Who are they?
They're the orderlies, or as we call them around here, the disorderlies.
Glad to meet ya. Nah, 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 nah. Oh, wise guy. What's wrong, Dr. Newhart? The CDDs?
Yep, it looks like the old hole in the heart problem to me.
Give me a break. You guys aren't even doctors.
Well, we may be plain old disorderlies, but we know all about heart trouble.
Yeah, from personal experience.
Let me break it down.
Let it be broke.
Yeah, yeah. What up, y'all? Y'all ready for this? Lucy, where you at? Lucy, uh-huh. You ready for this?
Uh-huh.
Where you at?
Teaching, teaching.
What up on a Friday night?
Teaching,
teaching, teaching. Yeah, CT, clap your hands. Yeah, ready? On the day that you were made, the Heavenly Father placed inside you everything that you need.
Need.
You got a stomach to eat with a liver underneath. You got two good lungs to breathe.
But the heart that beats just isn't complete. Throw a pump to all your veins.
Cha-cha.
There's an empty space, a little open place. And this hole in your heart, it has a name.
That holy, holy, holy hole. Break it down, D1. That holy, holy, holy hole. And Jesus is it, the only one that fits to fill that holy, holy hole.
This place down deep in your heart is a void that you try to avoid. But it aches and it stinks and you're empty, empty, empty. So you fill it with things, but the things don't bring any joy.
Yeah, yeah. So you party and you bop, you shop till you drop, but you still don't feel any peace.
Cha-ching.
And you try to hide that you're sad inside, but God knows your heart and He sees.
It's a holy, holy, holy hole. It's a holy, holy, holy hole. Aha. And Jesus is it, the only one that fits, that fills that holy, holy hole.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. When the Lord looks at you, here's what you ought to do. Put aside all your pride and believe that the baby in the hay grew to be a man one day, and He died on the cross for you and me.
Listen, so throw away your junk, don't have to be a monk, cause Jesus wants to see us have fun when He comes to live in you. And you.
And you,
you, you. When He comes to live in you, this is what He's gonna do. He will fill you, and you will become.
The only
one that says that feels the holy.
Oh yeah.
Peace.
Lord Knights, CTMCs, you better look out. We're coming after y'all.
Yeah.
Free Taco Bell Friday night.
Put it right here. Peace.
Those guys may have a point. Maybe we do have a hole in their heart.
Oh, no! Dr. Newhart, if we always had this holy hole, how come we really feel it on Christmas Day?
Well, you probably have had symptoms for some time now, but they're especially noticeable at Christmas.
Tell them why, Dr. Newhart.
Well, think about it. What is Christmas anyway?
A holiday.
That's right. And what is a holiday?
holiday means holy day.
Yes, it does. And of all the holidays, which is the holiest?
Why, Christmas, of course.
Very good. Now, someone tell me about Christmas.
Give me a break. You get presents, you go to parties, you get out of school.
Yeah.
Now, tell me what you know about the holy part.
The holy part?
Yes, Elizabeth.
Christmas makes me feel better already.
That's because you put something holy in your heart.
Yeah, I guess I'd forgotten about that part of Christmas. I guess I was just thinking about all the stuff I'd get.
No wonder we're in the dumps.
Well, I have to admit it. You did it, Dr. Newhart. We're all better now.
Hey, guys, we're cute.
Yeah, come on, Erin. But, guys...
No, I'm afraid you can't leave. Nurse Philpott, call the interns.
Paging Dr. Frick. Paging Dr. Frack. Paging Drs. Frick and Frack.
Of course, she's calling me again. My work is never done as a doctor.
Yes.
Block the doors, interns.
Yes, go. Go.
Oh, no! Hey, what is this?
Yeah, why can't we go? We told you we feel better.
Sure you do. We all feel better when we think of the manger, or go to carol services, or help someone need at Christmas. But that doesn't mean you still don't have heart trouble.
Look, Aaron, I know you're just trying to help, but we don't need to help anymore, okay?
Yeah! Yeah, we're leaving and we're leaving now.
Well, the last part of my examination was to hook you up to the heart monitor, but I can see that won't be necessary.
The heart monitor?
Yes. It's like a computer that lets you look and listen to your heart.
Great. We'll finally get to see this hole.
Oh, no. I'm afraid that only you and the Lord know what's inside your heart. But as long as we have this large hole in the middle of our face called a mouth, it's awfully hard to keep the contents of our heart a secret.
Then how can you tell what's inside, Dr. Newhart?
Well, Aaron, I think I have an idea. You go and let the interns hook you up to the heart monitor, and I'm going to go and look for a very special letter.
Did you take this class? Obviously, you didn't study because I was cheating off of you. All right. Oh, goodness, they should have had the disorderly to do this. Okay. Here we go. Mira, chica, hold still, okay? You move around too much. Okay, get it there at the heart.
This could be good, nurse. This could be good, doctors. I mean, judging from the letters I've seen, well, not that I checked into the mail, doctor.
What does she mean?
Well, your heart is where your desires are. You know, the things that you really want, and some people's desires, they aren't very holy.
Oh.
Let me put this on.
I can hear it.
I can hear it too. It's a very cool beat. Makes me want to move my feet. Toxic freak.
Oh, get a hold of yourself.
Oh, I'm sorry, Dr. Frack. That was before I come to know the Lord.
Well, we're glad for that. Now, here's the letter that I have from when Aaron came to visit last Christmas.
Do you want me to read it, Dr.
I want you to read it. And I want you to read it so that we will know what shape Aaron's heart is really, really in.
Okay. You don't mind if I read your letter? This is personal.
Okay, read it.
Too bad. You don't have to say so. Okay. Dear Dr. Newhart, that's you. My heart is so full of God's joy. It's my desire to delight in the Lord, to discover His word, to declare Him my King. This is the song that my new heart sings. Oh, Erin, this is beautiful. You wrote this letter? You're a very smart girl. You remind me of me. Oh. I will continue. This is the Lord's design, to devote this corazón for all you Spanish-speaking people, heart of mine. To do all He demands, I decrease, and He expands. What is the problem, Dr. Frack?
Dr. Frick, that letter makes me emotional. So beautiful.
It is beautiful. I think, Dr. Frack, we need a moment. Moment is over. I will continue,
please,
yes?
Please continue.
Thank you. My life will be just fine. Because you know what? You, me, I'm the branch, and He's divine.
Oh, that's cute. Divine.
Well, Nurse Philpott, I haven't seen you so cheerful in weeks.
Yes, I mean, maybe I... Oh, I better get back to my magazines. I mean, my paperwork.
So, Aaron, when did you get your new heart? Oh, it was when I came to see Dr. Newhart last Christmas. That's why I knew she could help you.
That's what makes you so happy.
TJ, why don't you and Corey try the heart monitor?
No, that's okay. I'll pass.
Me too.
But why?
Because I already know what's in my heart.
Yeah, a lot of junk.
Oh, yeah.
But you've just taken the first step towards getting a new heart.
We did?
Sure. First you examine your heart and you admit that what's inside isn't very holy. And then you ask God to replace it with something that is.
Like that holy night?
Like the one born on that holy night.
He fits perfectly, doesn't he, Aaron?
He sure does. And when he fills it, it becomes brand new.
So how did you do it, Aaron?
Yeah, tell us everything you did to get your new heart.
Well, Dr. Newhart told me what to say. It's just a simple prayer.
A simple prayer?
That's right, Nurse Philpott. Here, I'll show you.
See, God doesn't exclude our mind, but he wants us to include our hearts. It cannot be just a mental understanding of who God is. It's allowing God to be the Lord of your life. It's coming to a place where you bring your heart to Him, full of all the junk that we all have inside, and say, God, create in me a pure heart. Create in me, give me a new heart. As He says in Ezekiel, I will take your heart of stone and I will give you a heart of flesh. He doesn't want us to come to a production like this and enjoy the children, and they've done a great job, and leave with the same heart that we came in here with. God wants us to come to Him, not just with our minds, but with our whole hearts. And I'm going to ask us for just a moment, just to bow our heads and close our eyes. I know the lights are down dim. And I want you to begin to think, where is my heart today?
Where would I be? You only know. I'm glad you see through eyes of love, a hopeless gift, an empty place. If
that your Holy Spirit will live in their hearts from this day forward like never before. Even if they believed in you before, oh God, God, let them surrender to your Lordship today completely, Lord God. Completely, Lord God. Outside of all the religious rules, outside of all the religious rituals, oh God, but God, that they would have a personal relationship with you. Your heart to their heart. Their heart to your heart, oh God. Will you do that today, we ask, in Jesus' precious name, amen. Amen. Amen.
Most efficient. What did you forget?
Well, here it is, Christmas Day, and I haven't even wished you a Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, Doctor.
I believe that comes from your heart.
You might say a new heart.
You definitely might.
Okie dokie, Doc. Things are gonna be way different around here. Why, look at this place. Christmas Day, and we don't even have a tree.
You're right. How about some decorations?
Sure, do you have a tree somewhere?
Frickin' Fred, that's your department.
How about some garland?
Disorderlies, go for it.
I love red bows.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Don't forget the manger scene.
The manger scene? I'll take care of that.
Finally, this place is going to look like Christmas.
But isn't Christmas, like, almost over?
Heavens no. For you guys, Christmas has just begun.
Thank you.
You didn't see all the other people that were involved in this, but there are Just Kids workers downstairs, and they were here all day yesterday. I think they deserve a round of applause also. They're a little proud of Mike. They're an important part of what we did.